I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, indeterminate structure, that is both ends are fixed. This is the problem. An aluminium bar 3 mm long and 2500 mm square cross section area is rigidly fixed at A and D. I show you the figure. This is A and D, which is fixed here. A, D, this is B and C here. Determine the load shed and stress in each portion. You have to determine the load and the stresses in each portion. Distance through which B and C will move. This B and C will be moved. Take E is equal to 80, where E is nothing but 80 GPa. It can be written as 80 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Area is given as A is equal to 2500 mm square. Area is fixed here. Now let us consider three sections here, and the two assuming here we have to creating the equations. Assuming first part, section 1, 2, and 3, and this in terms of meter we have to convert into mm, 1000 mm, convert into multiplied by 1000 here. First section, section 1, or you can consider directly here, assuming it as tensile, I will consider P1. Next part I will consider here, the two tensile, P2. Third part I will consider here, P3. Now based on this one, I will create the equation in this way. That means we are assuming it here. It is positive, positive, negative, negative. Now P1 is positive, right? P1 minus P2 is equal to, direction is positive here. Therefore, you have to consider 200 kilonewton. Equation 1. Similarly, you have to consider the equation 2 here in this way, plus P2 minus P3 is equal to 125 kilonewton, positive here, positive. Equation 2, third equation, both ends are fixed here, therefore delta L is equal to 0, because both ends are fixed, ends are fixed here. Both ends are fixed. Therefore, you can write as delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 is equal to 0, because I am considering a tension. Now, what is delta 1? P1 L1 divided by AE plus P2 L2 divided by AE plus P3 L3 divided by AE is equal to 0. Young's modulus and area is same. There goes this side, therefore it becomes 0. And consider P1 is equal to L1, this become L1, L2 and L3. 1000 plus P2 into 1000 plus P3 into 1000 is equal to 0. These are the L1, L2 and L3. This become equation 3. Now, from the calculator, we are equating here. P1 minus P2 is equal to 200 kilonewton. P2 minus P3 is equal to 125 kilonewton. And this one, P1 into 1000 plus P2 into 1000 plus P3 into 1000 is equal to 0. 1, 2 and 3. With the help of calculator, we can directly find the result. Now, first you have to go to the setup, 5, 2, here 1, minus 1, P3 will be 0 here, no P3, 200, next 1 is 0, 2 is 1, minus 1, 125, next is 1000, thousand, zero. The answer is, now P1 is positive here, positive, P1 is equal to 175 kilonewton. That means the first assumption is correct. Next, P2 minus 25 kilonewton. The second assumption is, we have to reverse the direction now. Minus indicate it is a compressive. Third, P3 is equal to minus 150 kilonewton. It is 150 kilonewton. The minus indicate, we have to redraw the diagrams. Redraw the diagram. The first become compressive, sorry, tension. P1 is tensile, that is 175 kilonewton. 175 kilonewton. Second is compressive, 25 kilonewton. 25 kilonewton. One more, third is also compressive, 150 kilonewton. 150 kilonewton. Minus and minus, this becomes positive. It is obtained here. The minus indicate only the, this should be in compressive force. Minus indicate it should be compressive. The positive indicate it should be tensile. It is written here. Redraw. Now we are finding the stresses on, stresses for each section. Now stresses in each portion or each section. First section is, this is the first section. Consider sigma 1 is equal to P1 divided by area. What is P1? 175 into 10 raised to 3. Area will be 2500. Answer will be 70 Newton per mm square. It is tensile. Tensile. Sigma 2 is equal to P2 divided by area. P2 is how much? 25 into 10 raised to 3. Divided by 2500, the answer will be 10 Newton per mm square. It is compressive. Compressive force. Sigma 3 is equal to P3 divided by A. P3 is nothing but 150. 150 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 2500. The answer will be 60 Newton per mm square. It is also a compressive. Now, they have said it, the distance through which the portion B and C will move. B and C is nothing but B and C. This portion we have to consider. That means AB will, how it moves, and CD, how it moves, we are going to find out. Or you can find out the total, each portion elongation you can find out individually. Now, the distance. Distance through point B and C, that is delta L1 is equal to P1 L1 divided by A into E. What is P1? 175 into 10 raised to 3. L is nothing but 1000. L is nothing but 1000 here. Divided by area is 2500. Young's modulus is 80 into 10 raised to 3. The answer is 0.875 mm. Now, this is for AB. Now, for delta C, for delta CD, P3 is equal to L3 divided by AE. What is P3? 150 into 10 raised to 3. L is nothing but 1000. Divided by area 2500 into 80 into 10 raised to 3. You will get the answer 0.75 mm. Sorry, there is a disturbance outside. The dog is making the sound there. Sorry for the disturbance. In this way, you have to solve the problem. I am Satosh Gadamkar. Thank you very much.